Voila.
Whoa.
They weren't kidding about the way it smells. It's intense. It's kind of sulfur-like. It's kind of an instant flashback to the rugby socks I left in a PE kit once in school for a whole week.
Volatile aroma molecules from cheese or feet float into the air and get sucked up into your nose. Each smell compound stimulates a unique combination of receptors that allow us to identify the smell. In the case of epoisse, it's a smell of stinky feet that's not particularly pleasant or appetizing. So why, if it smells so bad, would anyone put it in their mouth?
But when you eat it, something magical happens. The aroma compounds are released in your mouth, and they waft up the back of your nose. And they're detected there by the same smell detectors. But weirdly, your brain perceives them as very different from if you were to smell forward and sniff them up the front of your nose.
It's called backward smelling. Rather than simply smelling the stink, the brain now combines the smell with the creamy taste it's experiencing on the tongue at the same time. This combination of taste and smell has a dramatic effect on how we perceive a particular odor molecule. And for the full effect, always eat the rind, since this is where many of the smells lie.
This stuff no longer is pungent and kind of animalic like your body, and suddenly sharp, garlicky, eggy. It's just warming, comforting deliciousness.